Hello everyone. So welcome back to our physics class. Now in today's class, we will continue with the revision of the second chapter, that is measurement, which is the part of your unit test 2. And in that case, I want to start with the topic hydrometer. As in the previous class, we had discussed about density and then we had talked about relative density. So relative density actually means the comparison of density of a substance with density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Now, what is hydrometer? Hydrometer is an instrument which is used to measure the relative density of liquid. Means it is used to compare the density of that particular liquid with density of water. And with the help of this instrument, you can know whether this liquid is denser than water or it is basically less denser than water. Then a hydrometer is commonly used to test purity of milk. So in big factories or companies where they use milk, they actually know how to they actually want to know the purity of milk. So how they check the purity of milk? They use hydrometer, which is used to test the purity of milk, and this hydrometer is known as lactometer. So if they ask the device which is used to test or check the purity of milk, that is lactometer. So lactometer is a kind of hydrometer. So you will say lactometer is a device which is used to test the purity of milk. Then after knowing the density of liquids, density of water, relative density, we should know the topic flotation and sinking. As I have already discussed this in detail earlier, that flotation or sinking means, suppose when a solid or any object is placed over a liquid, it may sink or it may go into float. So the condition applies over here, that if the density of that particular solid is less than liquid, okay, suppose the liquid is water and you put any object over that water, so if the density of that particular solid substance is less than water, then that object will going to float. If the density of that particular object is equal to density of water, then also it will going to float, but in that situation it will going to partially float and partially going to go inside water. So half of the body will be out of the water and half of the body will be inside water. But if that object's density is more than density of water, then in that situation that object will completely sink inside the liquid. Similarly, two liquids are poured in a container. So the liquid which is having higher density will going to go at the bottom, and the liquid which is having low density will going to float over that particular liquid. Like suppose you take water and oil. So you take water and pour some oil over that, then what will happen? Water will always settle at the bottom and oil will always float over the water, because the density of liquid, the oil, that is less than density of water. So two different densities, two different liquids having different densities, in that situation also one will going to float, one will going to sink. Similarly, solid also, if it is poured in a liquid and density is less, it will going to float, and if the density is more, then it may going to sink inside the liquid. Now let us talk about some applications which are based on the topic flotation. Okay, so the first one is the relative density of candle wax is 0.93. So the density of this wax, okay, which comes out from the candle, of which the candle is made up of, is actually 0.93. Density of water is 1. So since the density of this candle wax is less than 1, so it will going to float over water, and hence object made of wax floats on water. So this is the reason why objects which are made up of wax, they easily float over water. Then it is easier to swim in sea water as compared to river water. So why it is easier to swim in sea water? Because actually sea water consists of salt. Various kind of salts are present, and dissolved salts are there in huge quantity. And because of the presence of these salts, what happened? The density of seawater increases. But in case of river water, since the water is fresh water and the salt quantity is very, very less, the concentration of salt is very, very less, so the density of river water is less. So density of sea water is more and density of river water is less. So since density of sea water is more, it is easy for us to swim in sea water. Now next one, the density of ice is less than water. We know that the density of ice, since the temperature of ice is less than 4 degrees Celsius, that is near about 0 degree or minus, in that situation the density of ice is less than density of water, and this is the reason why ice floats over water, and that is why the icebergs also floats over water. Such a big massive quantity of icebergs are there which easily floats off over water because of its overall density, which is less than compared to the density of sea water or ocean. Now after talking about applications, let us talk about variation of density with temperature. Means due to change in temperature because of the providing of the heat energy and taking away of heat energy, the density of a substance changes. So how it happens? So let us talk about that topic. For a fixed mass of substance, suppose any object is there which is having a fixed mass. Suppose I will take 1 kg of solid object, okay? So a fixed mass of a substance is there. The density of substance changes due to the change in its volume. So what will happen? Suppose a solid is there of 1 kg mass. Now if you heat this object or you cool this object, will the mass of the substance changes? No, the mass of substance never changes. So the mass of a substance remains constant. But as soon as you start heating the substance, generally on heating, the objects expand. So the volume of that substance expands. Whereas on cooling, the volume of that substance decreases, that it contracts. So what happens? We know that the formula of density is mass upon volume. Now we know that whenever you heat an object or you cool an object, while changing the temperature of an object, the mass will never going to change. The mass of that particular substance will remain fixed. So this is fixed right now. Now on heating, the volume expands, increases. So when the volume increases, what will happen? The overall value will going to decrease, that is the density decreases. So due to expansion and contraction, the density of substance also changes. So when you heat an object, the expansion takes place, the volume increases, and since the volume increases, the density decreases. So on heating, density decreases. Similarly, on cooling, the density increases because the volume will also grow, decrease. So they are just inverse of each, that density and volume are just inversely proportional to each other. If the volume increases, the density decreases, and if the volume decreases, the density will going to increase. So this is how the temperature affects the density of a substance. If the temperature will increase, so slowly and slowly volume will also going to increase, and since the volume is increasing, the density is obviously going to decrease. So this is for general methods, and generally this is all takes place, and because of this reason, the possibility of convection currents takes place. So let us talk about convection current. Now since there is change in density due to change in temperature, the convection current occurs in liquid also and gases also. So why it occurs only in liquid and gases? Because both liquid and gases can flow, solids cannot flow. So generally the process of convection and convection current cannot be seen in solid, but it can be seen in liquid and gases. So what actually happens? Suppose if I take a container consisting of water, that is liquid, okay, and place it over the burner. Okay, and I'll allow that water to heat. So what will happen? The heat energy will going to transform from this burner into water, and water will start absorbing the heat energy. As soon as the water starts heating, what will happen? The expansion will take place. The molecule of water will going to separate. because as we have studied in the first chapter also, that whenever you heat liquid, the molecule will start moving apart. And because the molecules are moving away, the density decreases. So on heating liquid or on heating water, the density of water decreases. And when the density of water decreases, it becomes lighter. And light water molecules will going to rise up. When they will going to rise up, the cold water molecules which were already placed, they will going to come and settle at the bottom. Now, when they will come and settle at the bottom, they will also get heated up very quickly, and they will also going to expand, and due to expansion, they will again going to rise up. So this moving of liquid in the upward direction and another liquid molecules to replace, this whole circle is known as convection current. Okay, this is actually known as convection current. The same thing happens with air also. Okay, so what happens? Suppose air is present. So air will be present near to the surface of the earth also, and air will be present above the surface of the earth also. Now suppose the land becomes very, very hot during the daytime when the temperature is very, very high. So the land becomes very, very hot. So what will happen? It will going to release the heat energy, and what will happen? The air near the surface of the earth will become very warm. When the air near the surface of the earth becomes very warm, what will happen? It will going to expand because of heat energy. The expansion process will take place, and the light air which is near to the surface of the earth, it rises up. And in that condition, the cold air which was above, it will going to come at the bottom. It will again going to get heated up. It will going to rise, and this whole circulation will going to take place continuously. This circulation is actually known as convection current. The same thing happens inside your kitchen also, where the burner or gas is working right now. Your parents are preparing food. Lot of heat energy has been released, and this heat energy rises up. When it rises up, we place exhaust on the top from where this hot air can release out, and cold air can replace it from the windows. So this is because of the convection current, and many applications are there which you have to study which are related to convection current, like air condition. Why air conditions are placed on the top at a height? Because when these air conditions, they will take away the heat energy, they will throw it out, and they will going to give the cold energy, cold air inside the room. So cold air is heavier because the density is more. It will going to come down, and the hot air which is lighter, it will going to rise up, and it will be utilized by the air condition, and it will going to supply outside. So this is how air conditions are placed out at the top at a height inside your room. So this is all about the convection current, and this is also because of variation of density with temperature. So these things you have to revise about this chapter, which is related to this chapter. Try to learn all the important words or the definitions which I have told you. Read out all the that fill in the blanks, question and answers, everything. Read the chapter thoroughly so that you may able to answer each and every kind of question which is there in the chapter. Thank you, everyone.